हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द वर्ल्ड ऑफ रोहित डामरेज यूट्यूब चैनल। इफ़ यू स्टिल नॉट सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल देन प्लीज सब्सक्राइब माय चैनल एंड इफ़ यू रियली लाइक माय वीडियोस देन प्लीज गिव लाइक्स टू माय वीडियो। माय सेल्फ मिस्टर रोहित सुरेश डामरे, आई एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट टीचर इन सुंदरबाई मराठी विद्यालय खराड़ी पुणे 14। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट स्टैंडर्ड 9th सब्जेक्ट साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी चैप्टर नंबर 1 दैट इज लॉज ऑफ मोशन। इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट न्यूटन्स लॉज ऑफ मोशन। देयर आर 3 लॉज ऑफ मोशंस। न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन। द स्टेटमेंट फॉर द न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ ऑफ मोशन इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट कंटिन्यूज टू रिमेन एट रेस्ट और इन अ स्टेट ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म मोशन अलॉन्ग अ स्ट्रेट लाइन अनलेस एन एक्सटर्नल अनबैलेंस्ड फोर्स एक्ट्स ऑन इट। सो द न्यूटन्स फर्स्ट लॉ इट एक्सप्लेन्स द फेनोमेनॉन ऑफ इनर्शिया दैट इज the inability of an object to change its state of motion on its own. It also explains the unbalanced forces which causes a change in the state of object at rest or in uniform motion. It means an object always remain in its state of rest or in a state of uniform motion unless any external unbalanced force is acting on it. Second law of motion. The rate of change of momentum is proportional to the applied force, and the change of momentum occurs in the direction of the force. This is the statement of Newton's second law of motion. Now, what is momentum? So whenever two objects they are striking one another, then the effect of that striking, it is depending on the both mass of the former object and its velocity. This means that the effect of the force depends on a property related to both mass and velocity of the striking object. This property was termed as momentum by the Newton. So let's study what is momentum. Momentum is the product of mass of product of mass and velocity of an object. So the formula becomes P is equals to m into v. P is equals to mv. Momentum, it is a vector quantity, that is it has magnitude as well as direction. Okay, now the rate of change of momentum, it is equal to the change in momentum divided by time. Therefore rate of change of momentum is equals to in bracket mv minus mu. M is the mass, v is the velocity. Okay, m is the mass and u is the initial velocity, while v is the final velocity, t is the time. So finally we get rate of change of momentum is equals to m into a, because v minus u upon t, it is nothing but the acceleration. So therefore f is equals to ma, and f is equals to k into ma. K is constant. So we get final statement, that is F is equals to M into A. Newton's third law of motion. Now the statement for the Newton's third law of motion is every action force has an equal and opposite reaction force which acts simultaneously. यू मस्ट हैव सीन एग्जाम्पल्स फॉर दिस न्यूटन्स थर्ड लॉ ऑफ मोशन इन योर डे टू डे लाइफ. ओके, लाइक व्हाइल हिटिंग अ बॉल विथ अ बैट द स्पीड ऑफ द बैट डिक्रीजेस, और अ गन रिकॉइल्स दैट इज मूव बैकवर्ड्स व्हेन अ बुलेट इज फायर्ड, और मैकेनिज्म ऑफ फायरिंग ऑफ अ रॉकेट. सो व्हेन रॉकेट इज लॉन्च इट इज द fuel it is ignited and that goes in backward or downward direction, but the displacement of the rocket is in upward direction. So this is the Newton's third law of motion, that every action has an equal and opposite reaction force and they are acting simultaneously. Okay, then the next concept is law of conservation of momentum. When no external force acts on two interacting objects, their total momentum remains constant. It does not change. When two objects collide, the total momentum before collision is equal to the total momentum after collision. So this is the law of conservation of momentum. Thank you very much. If you really like my videos, then please like, share and comment on my videos. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you again.